Yellowstone in northwest Wyoming, land of geysers, mountains, and lakes, is also sitting atop a super volcano. And it just took what scientists describe as a deep breath, causing miles of ground to rise dramatically. So what does this mean?
When it blows, it could destroy the United States as we know it.
All right, so when we talk about this, and we have pictures, pictures of Mount St. Helens erupting back in 1980. Let's just show this right now. You say that an explosion with this supervolcano under Yellowstone, and there we're seeing Mount St. Helens, would be 1,000 times bigger than this. What type of damage are we talking about here?
We're talking about immediate damage up to 100 miles from the site and the total devastation, basically wiping out everything in sight. However, the real damage goes up to 500 miles into the volcano, and poisonous gases, death of wildlife and vegetation, and that's a ring about 1,000 miles across. That's the heartline of America. It would wipe out the United States as we know it. And again, we don't want to panic anybody. It could happen tomorrow, or it could happen 100,000 years from now. It's black magic trying to predict exactly when it's going to blow, but we do know one day, it will blow. Starts to rise, more and more earthquakes take place, more ash, volcanic gases start to be unleashed. That's about the only warning we get, because we do not have a good way to predict volcanic eruptions.
It's amazing. So you say it could be tomorrow, it could be in 100,000 years, but it's under there.
It will destroy North America as we know.
Biblical march toward apocalypse is about to get even worse. It's a disaster that conjures up images of hell itself. Scientists at Yellowstone take measurements. Something strange is happening. Could it be the site of a future biblical disaster? It's one of the most dangerous and destructive forces on Earth. Could one of the seven signs be a volcano? A look back at ancient history provides a clue. The images of fire and brimstone that define hell were inspired by the flaming magma and sulfuric gas emitted by volcanoes. Like many violent natural events, volcanic eruptions are seen by our Christian ancestors as the result of God's wrath. The eruption buries the Roman city of Pompeii. Hot volcanic ash entombs thousands of victims for all time, frozen in their final agony. Many early Christians view this as God's punishment of the pagan Roman Empire, exacted for persecuting their Christian brethren.
A volcanic eruption is an indication that God is in control of the earth, that he is the one who controls these natural phenomena.
We know too well the power of volcanoes today. Mount St. Helens in 1980, Mount Pinatubo in 1991. These eruptions and countless others have caused humans pain and suffering on an immense scale. Are there, in fact, volcanoes large enough to cause such an apocalypse? Science now confirms that there are. And just as the prophecy describes, they can be hidden in oceans or even right below us. It's a phenomenon called supervolcanoes.
A supervolcano is any volcano that emits 100 cubic kilometers or more of ash in a single eruption.
That's about 100 to 150 times more than Mount St. Helens ejected in 1980. and there are supervolcanoes scattered across the globe.
Taupo in New Zealand, a popular fishing resort on the North Island. Santorini in the Aegean. The Campi Flegrei, just west of Naples, where several hundred thousand people live.
There are at least 8 supervolcanoes around the world, but they're hard to find, since they usually don't take the form of a mountain.
Most volcanoes, when they erupt explosively, leave a crater, a violent expulsion of magma that blows its roof off. When a very large eruption occurs, it leaves something called a caldera, which is a much more structured, bowl-shaped depression that has relatively steep walls. It's typically tens of kilometers across, and it forms by a settling of the roof rocks down into what used to be the magma chamber.
There are several supervolcano calderas within the United States. One of the most beautiful sights may also pose the greatest threat of devastation.
Yellowstone is a large volcanic crater measuring 35 by 45 miles.
It's just shocking to imagine a single eruption that would evacuate so much magma and create a valley where there was nothing.
But that's exactly what happened at Yellowstone more than once.
Yellowstone has had 3 very big eruptions that were hundreds of cubic kilometers or more.
However, believers examining the prophecy and scientists investigating the data do agree on one thing. If a supervolcano does erupt, our prospects will be bleak.
The first thing that would happen would be a series of minor eruptions. They don't erupt simultaneously around the entire circumference of the caldera. Instead, they punch a single hole through the edge of the caldera, and then they unzip the caldera rim by migrating that eruption center around its circumference.
Once this happens, the entire floor of the Yellowstone caldera will collapse. That will blast a gigantic column of scalding volcanic gas and ash up to 20 kilometers high into the atmosphere.
That cloud collapses in places and produces a ground-hugging mass of hot ash that runs perhaps several hundred miles down river valleys.
Anyone and anything within that range would almost certainly be buried and killed.
As we've learned from many previous eruptions, the victims suffer a terrible death.
What kills people is the ingestion of hot gases that cook you from the inside.
The ash that remains airborne is carried westward by the prevailing winds.
11 western states, including a substantial part of California, become blanketed in ash. You're looking at a destruction of the grain belt in the Midwest, upon which a substantial part of the world's population living at margin depends. And with that, then, a realignment of the geopolitical balance of power.